The joy of the circus is something Territorians don't experience very often, particularly those in remote communities. But Circus Oz has taken touring to the next level, lugging tons of gear thousands of kilometres across the Top End and Central Australia. It's circus at its best, with pro bono shows and workshops for some of Australia's most disadvantaged. Stateline travelled with the troupe on one of these special expeditions.
It's an unlikely place for a world-class circus performance, but Circus Oz has gone off the beaten track to take its show to the Binjari Aboriginal Community, about 20 kilometres southwest of Katherine.
It's just something we love doing. It's just a wonderful thing to do, and it brings joy to everyone.
It's beautiful to be able to bring something to them and open up their world, say there's other stuff going on out apart from what's going on here.
It's a bounce in morale that's sorely needed here in Binjari. Although alcohol has been banned here since 1996, high rates of alcohol abuse, violence and killings continue.
I think the problems need to be addressed not at the alcohol stage, it needs to be addressed before that, and getting people motivated, getting people enjoying themselves and feeling good, and hopefully that's what the circus will do.
The local basketball stadium has been transformed into a gym. Of the 300 people who live in Binjari, a third are school-aged children, and they're throwing themselves into the Circus Oz workshops.
The show is for everyone, and we're trying to make a show that's for the broadest possible audience, and somewhere between, like, AFL and clowning and sport and tumbling, it just feels like it locks right in with the way that these kids love to play with each other anyway.
The skill level is 10 times higher with these guys than it is with inner city kids, easily.
They develop this amazing loose tumbling skill that is beautiful to watch, because it's just this sort of gangly and impulsive, and it's about play. I mean, they're really great physical performers.
It's a welcome boost in self-esteem for children who struggle with overcrowding and a lack of resources, and who fall well below national indicators for education and health.
We still have underweight children, so our growth action assessment is still down. Our anemia rate's always been quite high and is still there. We're not making much improvement there. But we do have good attendance, but it's a slow process to see that change.
I reckon it's a big hit for the kids. Other communities, they have AFL players, go visit them. They even have Ian Thorpe when out there, read in the newspaper and stuff, you know. But it's, I reckon for here, for Binjari, it's a big hit.
Welcome to Sir!
This is the first time any of these children have been to a circus, and it's a huge hit. Circus Oz has no animals, just live music, acting, and some creative costume making. It's a circus based on principles of tolerance and equality.
From the very beginning, Circus Oz was a political company about stuff like land rights and nuclear disarmament. And then underneath all of that really is the idea that the show is for everyone, and we're trying to make a show that's for the broadest possible audience.
Put your paws in the air!
The circus is based in Melbourne and has been running for more than 30 years. It's multitasking at its best, with acrobats acting as magicians and jugglers trying their hand at comedy. The show transcends language and culture.
Circus is a bit like that. If you can't speak the language, you can still speak through circus.
It's not like gymnastics where it's like competitive to see who can be the best at anything. And the style of it is fundamentally irreverent, like cheeky, and it's like sort of Keystone Cops crossed with Buster Keaton.
Many of these performers got their break through community circus programs. They say similar programs in Indigenous communities could lead to amazing things.
It's a bit of a passion of mine at the moment, actually, is this notion of a national Indigenous circus company arising, and it will, because the groundswell is there. I mean, there's some great things going on.
For now, though, the community is just rapt that the circus came to town.
As I walk down the street, they're in the sand pit, they're doing flips, and they're springing off old bunks with springs and stuff.
The exposure to something that's world class is a good thing, and that hopefully they can just build their self-esteem and know that they can go on and do things.
Thank you.